Morning.
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 Happy Monday.
Morning.
Let's see, Rhonda, it looks like you are our officiant and Ann Parker, our reader today. And I'm going to put, we said it was Broadway Wednesday, is that what Rob has helped with the music? And what Rhonda sent today, I put at the end. It's very graphic, but it goes along with our Broadway Wednesday. Because it's an enactment of the crucifixion. But I am going to do that at the end. But go ahead, Rhonda. It's all you can.
Yeah, just to warn you, I don't know if any of y'all have seen The Passion of the Christ that Mel Gibson did years ago, but there are clips in that, and it's a very powerful song. I encourage you to stay, but if you don't, I get it. Good morning.
Morning.
Good morning.
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 It is 8 o'clock on the Wednesday in Holy Week, and I am going to ask real quick if Miss Pat, do you mind reading the Venite?
No, that'll be fine.
Okay. And Miss Janet, do you mind reading the prayer of St. Chrysostom at the end?
Not at all. I'd be delighted.
Great.
Thank you.
Okay. Well, after opening sentences, we'll begin on page 79 in the Book of Common Prayer. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ. If you continue in my word, you are truly my disciples, and you will know the truth, and the truth will make you free. Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor.
Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done, by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbor as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. In the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us. That we may delight in your will and walk in your ways. For in your name, amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us all our sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen us in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep us in eternal life. Amen.
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 Continuing with the invitatory on page 80, Lord, open our lips.
And our mouths shall be praise.
Glory to the Father.
To the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and forever.
Amen. The Lord is full of compassion and mercy. Come, let us adore him.
Come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us shout for joy to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving and raise a loud shout to him with song. The Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hands are the caverns of the earth, and the heights of the hills are his also. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands have molded the dry land. Come, let us bow down and bend the knee, and kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture, and the sheep of his hand. Oh, that today we would hearken to his voice.
The Psalms appointed today is Psalm 55. It's found on page 660 in your Book of Common Prayer. Psalm 55, page 660. And we will read responsively, breaking at the asterisk. Hear my prayer, O God.
Do not hide yourself from my petition.
Listen to me and answer me.
I have no peace because of my cares.
I am shaken by the noise of the enemy.
And by the pressure of the wicked.
For they have cast an evil spell upon me. My heart quakes within me.
And the terrors of the dead fall upon me.
Fear and trembling have come over me.
And the horror overwhelms me.
And I said, oh, that I had wings like a dove.
I would fly away and be at rest.
I would flee to a far off place.
And make my life in the wilderness.
I would hasten to escape.
From the stormy wind and the tempest.
Swallow them up, O Lord, confound their speech.
For I have seen violence and strife in the city.
Day and night, the watchmen make their rounds upon her walls.
But trouble and mystery are in the midst of her.
There is corruption at her heart.
Her streets are never free of oppression and deceit.
For had it been an adversary who taunted me, then I could have borne it.
Or had it been a man who taunted himself against me, then I could have hidden from him.
But it was you, a man after my own heart.
My companion, my own.
We took sweet counsel together.
And walked with the throng in the house of God.
Let death come upon them suddenly. Let them go down alive into the grave.
For wickedness is in their dwellings, in their very midst.
But I will call upon God.
And the Lord will deliver me.
In the evening, in the morning, and at noonday, I will complain and lament.
And he will hear my voice.
He will bring me safely back from the battle waged against me.
For they are in me who fight me.
God, who is enthroned of old, will hear me and bring them down.
They never change. They do not fear God.
My companion stretched forth his hand against his comrade.
He has broken his covenant.
His speech is softer than butter.
But war is in his heart.
His words are smoother than oil.
But they are drawn on swords.
Cast your burden upon the Lord, and he will sustain you.
He will never let the righteous stumble.
For you will bring the bloodthirsty and deceitful
down to the pit of destruction.
They shall not live out half their days.
But I will trust my peace in you.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
All right, we're going to have our lessons and some music in between, read by Miss Ann Parker. And if y'all can mute until after the Apostles' Creed, that would be lovely.
A reading from the book of Jeremiah. Thus says the Lord, cursed are those who trust in mere mortals and make mere flesh their strength, whose hearts turn away from the Lord. They shall be like a shrub in the desert and shall not see when relief comes. They shall live in the parched places of the wilderness, in an uninhabited salt land. Blessed are those who trust in the Lord, whose trust is the Lord. They shall be like a tree planted by water, sending out its roots by the stream. It shall not fear when heat comes, and its leaves shall stay green. In the year of drought it is not anxious, and it does not cease to bear fruit. The heart is devious above all else. It is perverse. Who can understand it? I, the Lord, test the mind and search the heart, to give to all according to their ways, according to the fruit of their doings. Heal me, O Lord, and I shall be healed. Save me, and I shall be saved. For you are my praise. See how they say to me, where is the word of the Lord? Let it come. But I have not run away from being a shepherd in your service, nor have I desired the fatal day. You know what came from my lips. It was before your face. Do not become a terror to me. You are my refuge in the day of disaster. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I dreamed I met a Galilean, a most amazing man. He had that look you very rarely find, the haunting, haunted kind. I asked him to say what had happened, how it all began. I asked again, he never said a word, as if he hadn't heard. And next, the room was full of wild and angry men. They seemed to hate this man. They fell on him and then disappeared again. Then I saw thousands of millions crying for this man. And then I heard them mentioning my name and leaving me the blame.
A reading from the Gospel according to John. Jesus said, "Now my soul is troubled, and what should I say? Father, save me from this hour? No, it is for this reason that I have come to this hour. Father, glorify your name." Then a voice came from heaven, "I've glorified it, and I will glorify it again." The crowd standing there heard it and said that it was thunder. Others said an angel had spoken to him. And Jesus answered, "This voice has come for your sake, not for mine. Now is the judgment of the world. Now the ruler of the world will be driven out. And I, when I am lifted up from the earth, will draw all people to myself." He said this to indicate the kind of death he was to die. The crowd answered him, "We've heard from the law that the Messiah remains forever. How can you say that the Son of Man must be lifted up? Who is the Son of Man?" And Jesus said to him, "The light is with you for a little longer. Walk while you have the light, so that the darkness may not overtake you. If you walk in the darkness, you do not know where you're going. While you have the light, believe in the light so that you may become children of light." After Jesus had said this, he departed and hid from them. Here ends the lesson.
The Apostles' Creed is found on page 96. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Moving on to the prayers. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Amen. Suffrages be on page 98. Save your people, Lord, and bless your inheritance.
Govern them now and always.
Day by day, we bless you.
We praise your name forever.
Lord, keep us from all sin today.
Have mercy on us, Lord. Have mercy.
Lord, show us your love and mercy.
For we put our trust in you.
And you, Lord, is our hope.
And we shall never hope in vain.
Lord God, whose blessed Son, our Savior, gave his body to be whipped and his face to be spit upon, give us grace to accept joyfully the sufferings of the present time, confident of the glory that shall be revealed, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. Good Lord, deliver us. Receive these prayers, O Lord our God, to give all your people increase of grace, to hear your word with humility, to receive it with pure affection, and to bring forth the fruit of the Spirit. Lord, in your mercy, to bring into the way of truth all who have erred and are deceived. Lord, in your mercy, to rule the hearts of your servant Joseph, the President of the United States, and all others in authority, that they may do justice and show mercy and walk humbly before you. Lord, in your mercy, to make wars to cease in all the world and to give all nations unity, peace, and concord. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
To show mercy on all prisoners and captives, refugees, the homeless and the hungry, and all those who are desolate and oppressed. Lord, in your mercy, to support, help, and deliver all who are in danger, necessity, and tribulation. Lord, in your mercy, to give us true repentance, to forgive us all our sin, negligence, and ignorance, and to endue us with the grace of your Holy Spirit to amend our lives according to your holy word. Lord, in your mercy, to forgive our enemies, persecutors, and slanderers, and to turn their hearts. Lord, in your mercy, to grant to all the faithful departed eternal life and peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
To grant that in the fellowship of St. James and all the saints, we may attain to your heavenly kingdom. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy, through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Almighty God, you know the needs of your church in every place. Look graciously upon the people of St. James Parish and grant us the guidance of your Holy Spirit as we move through the search process for a new rector. Thank you for the faithful stewards you have provided and will provide for our leadership. Thank you for those who have agreed to serve on the search committee and for the ministry of our wardens and vestry. We thank you for the new rector you are preparing to serve among us, whoever and wherever he or she may be. Give us discernment, wisdom, patience, and confidence in your timing. Help us to care for each other with mutual trust, respect, kindness, and clarity of purpose. You are the Good Shepherd, and we ask you to shepherd us throughout this journey. In the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
We offer prayers for those of us known in our community. And after Cheryl reads the names, you can add anyone that you'd like to pray for in the list in the chat or say names aloud.
Praying for Dave, James, Laura, Missy Wright, Jocelyn, Michael, Mary Ann, Jenny Knipe, Leonard, and Bob.
We also pray for Sally, Joel, Dwayne, the Anderson family, Heather, Jane, Susan, Carol, Aaron, Glenda, Adriana, Francis, Kit, Kathy, Brenda, Elizabeth, Patty, Fran, Bill, Kathy, Danny, Blake, Liz, Ed, Posey and Meredith, for Charlie Statler, for Bob and Carolyn, for Vivian and Marvin. There are others you'd like to add?
Pray for Linda.
Well, how about some Thanksgivings this morning?
Beautiful day.
I continue to give Thanksgiving for the service last night. It was very peaceful and serene, and it was lovely.
I was absolutely amazed for all the people that went into creating that. I was able to just worship.
At this time, Miss Janet will sum up our prayers in the words of St. Chrysostom.
And one thing, the music that Rhonda chose to come right after this, she has just given a warning that it's somewhat graphic. Would you say that? Okay. So just so you know that about the passion.
And Janet, you're on mute.
Okay. Thank you. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplication to you. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen.
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 I am a thief. I am a murderer. Walking on this lonely hill. What have I done? That my time is coming soon. It's been so long, oh, such a long time since I've lived with peace and rest, and now I am here at my destination, and I guess things work for the best. And I know that my time is coming soon.
Holy and sovereign Lord, when the earth and all its people quake, you hold its pillars firm. What is uncertain and frightening to us is completely known to you and controlled by you. Look mercifully on the people of St. James and other parishes represented here. Although at this time we are apart from each other, we pray your Holy Spirit will unite us as one. Pour upon us your peace, which passes all understanding. Keep us safe and healthy, and above all, keep us mindful of those to whom we should show the love and compassion of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God.
Almighty God, we pray you graciously to behold this, your family, for whom our Lord Jesus Christ was willing to be betrayed and given into the hands of sinners and to suffer death upon the cross, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
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 Thank you, Rhonda. Thanks, everybody. And I hope to see you at our services Monday, Thursday, Good Friday. We've got the Easter Vigil and then, of course, Easter Day. So. See you next time.
Take care, God
bless.
See you tomorrow. Thank you, Rhonda.